So the next thing I'm going to cover is image processing and calibration. So this is a relatively short step to cover, but there's a few things to discuss. So one thing is, you know, we want to go from our rated image to you know, a calibrated image. And this has much fewer steps than that ramp fitting stage, but does do important things such as converting, you know, from detector pixel detector like count units to an actual flux in Jansky's Pistol Radian or whatever the pipeline prefers for that particular data set. And it will do things like a flat field correction. So what we found is that from a few tweaks with SpaceClip, we can get much, much better cleaned these image processed files. And you can see an example here on the right with the GIF. You can see a lot of this extra like scattered, all these extra bright pixels, hot pixels are being much, much better corrected for. And the image is a lot more cleaner in general. So SpaceClip lets you do this in a variety of different ways. You can use the DQ array, so this data quality array. It can flag different pixels based on that to correct them or ignore them potentially. It can do temporal variations, so it can look at each pixel in time and say, you know, has this pixel jumped for some reason when it really shouldn't, and correct it accordingly. It can do spatial variations, although I think this is a little dangerous. You know, it can look for these hot pixels spatially. And the only thing is it can sometimes get confused if it's, you know, near the edge of a bright pixel that is something real. It can sometimes think that's fake. And then finally, we can also have like a custom pixel mask. So this is, you know, you manually assign, you know, I know this pixel is bad. Please just correct for it. We'll go back to the live demo and all those ramp fit files should be done now. Yeah, so you have all our ratings files is the ones we care about. Just if you're interested, this rate file is an average of all of the ratings files. It's just mean combine or median combine of all of them. But SpaceClip pretty much exclusively works at the integration level. So we'll be sticking with these integration files. And then we also have these kind of log files, which are just a sort of description of what the terminal printing has done and, you know, what were your initial inputs to the code. Okay, so image processing we have here. So again, we're just setting some input directory stuff. We're saying we're looking for the ratings files. Do we want to do the default JWST outlier correction from the pipeline? Do we want to do just the outlier correction? You know, this is more used if we've already performed the correction itself, then we don't need to really go back and do it again. We can just do the cleaning on top of the images that have already been put together. And then here are a bunch of different parameters for the sort of correction we want to do. So here this says none. We might want to change that to something like DQ. I know this might not seem very apparent right now, but it will be as you test the code more. But DQ med, so we can do a correction based on the data quality array. We can do some correction based on the variation in time. And we can do a correction based on a custom pixel mask. So you can just add these together with these pluses and SpaceClip will do them one at a time. And we also have like a different routine called BP clean, but I won't get into that at the moment. And then here are just some different parameters for those different outlier corrections. So I won't dig into these all right now, but you can kind of imagine what they might be, you know, sort of how broader sigma am I going to consider when I'm blurring my image, if I'm blurring a pixel in time or I'm blurring it spatially. What sort of data quality threshold will I consider as actually a bad pixel? Or what fraction of a variation will I consider as some variation in time that I need to correct for? And then this is just a custom pixel mask that I'm inputting. So we can hit go on that again and then just run the image process. And you can see a whole new folder has been created up here called image process. And it's going to go through and create all these cleaned images. This is a lot quicker than the ramp fitting step, just because we don't need to do ramp fitting. Essentially, there's just less images to work with. So I've open one of these up. We can start to look at the image, and you can see it's pretty clean. You know, maybe there's some features left over, but the hope is, you know, they'll kind of get removed as we perform the PSF subtraction later on. And yeah, that's pretty much done now. You might be thinking, well, okay, how beneficial really is all of those extra steps? You know, why do we need to, or why would you suggest even starting at this lowest level pipeline stage? Can we not just start from the later levels? Is the pipeline not good enough? And I would say that there's a big difference at the moment. I think the pipeline is definitely going to improve in time, but this is PSF subtraction performed in space clips, so not with the JUSD pipeline. And you can see that using the default products we get versus using the space clip extra processing and these tiny tweaks we make really make a big difference in this final image. There's a lot of, you know, residual kind of gunk in the image that we're trying to correct for, that's left over.